What is up, Mephers? Hope you guys are having an amazing freaking day. I was doing some searching through my videos in the past, and I wanted to give you guys a tip video because the weather kind of sucks outside today, and the fish isn't very good around here. And I realized, although it's a bait that I use a lot, it's a rig system I use a lot, I should say, I've caught a lot of fish on it in my videos, and I'm going to be catching a lot of fish on it in the next couple months. I have yet to make a video using this crazy looking contraption right here, known as the Alabama rig, the umbrella rig, and it is an absolute deadly effective way to catch fish right now. This is when you want to be throwing it. So in today's video, I'm going to tell you guys everything that I personally have learned throwing this bait. Nothing that I've read, nothing that I've heard. I'm going to tell you exactly what I personally have learned, which is what I always try to give you guys. I'm not going to give you the whole rundown about how the Alabama rig came around, who started throwing it, and when it got famous or anything. No, we're going to talk today about what rigs I like to throw that I've had the most success with, when to throw this bait, how to throw this bait, where to throw it, what baits to put on the back, a little bit of everything to help you get out and catch more fish. That's the goal of this video, help you catch more fish on this crazy looking contraption right here. Okay, let's dig in. All right, so first off, let's talk about the most important thing. What rig should you go out and buy? There's a million different Alabama rigs in the market. They are not created equal. There's very, very small definitive things that are different with them, whether it be if they have blades on them, very importantly, how thick the wire gauge is, how many wires are actually on the rig. There's all different types of things. And to me, it comes down to, I throw three different types of rigs. These are three rigs that are, they're all different from each other, but they all work extremely effective for me in the waters that I fish. First one I like to throw is this guy right here. This is called the G-Funk rig, I believe, on Tackle Warehouse. It's like a custom-made rig. The reason I like this one, maybe the best out of all of them that I've ever used, I don't work with this company or anything, but it has very, very light wires, which we're going to talk about that in a little bit. But when you hit this bait or pulse it, all those baits kind of expand and collapse like a school bait fish does when they're getting chased or even just naturally moving throughout the water. This is my favorite version right here. It comes with six wires on it. It has five blades, so five of those outside wires have blades. The one in the middle does not. Now, my favorite feature about this rig right here is because I fish a lot in Missouri. Whenever I'm fishing the Alabama rig, usually it's on those highland reservoirs. We'll talk more about where and how and when to throw these in just a second. But anyways, in Missouri, you can only have three baits with hooks on your rig. That's very important to go check out so you don't go throw something with five hooks like this in a state where you can't have that many hooks. So check your local regulations. This rig right here comes designed with these three guys right here. So you got three wires that are on the top and they're shorter. So they sit further forward of these three bottom ones here. And those are for the dummy rigs, little teaser rigs, which are basically baits that you're going to put on there with a little spring lock. And we're going to talk about accessories in a second too. To me, it's very, very important that those are further forward, and this is the only rig that I know of really that's this light of wire, has six different wires on it and has three that are sitting forward. This is made for three bait fishing, three hook fishing rigging anyways. As you fish these more and more, you'll learn that the fish almost every single time will hit the one in the middle that's the furthest back, or they'll hit one of the two bottom ones. They don't usually come from the sides and eat this bait. They don't ever come from the top and hit this bait, not that I know of anyways. You're always going to be fishing this bait to be sitting over the top of fish or coming by the side of fish. So they're going to hit it from an upward type angle, and they're almost always going to get these. So not only are your hooks going to be in the middle and on the bottom, they're going to be set back a little bit further. That is why I freaking love this G-Funk rig. Also comes built in with a swivel on the top, so you're not going to get any line twist. This guy's a killer. Another one I like, if you guys like really small compact rigs, and we'll talk about when to throw those guys in just a second. This one right here, it's a cheap one. It's very, very simple. The Yum Flash Mob Junior. So this is the smallest version of it. It's got five wires. All five of them have swivels on them, so you can put five hooks on them. You can put one hook on them. You can put dummies on them, whatever you want to. And then, of course, it comes with four really, really small willow leaf blades. And this guy's like super, super light. That's one thing I like about this one. If you want to throw a super compact rig and you want one that's really, really light, maybe you're fishing it not very deep, or you're fishing it very deep and you want to just slowly crawl that thing along, this is the rig for you. Now we got this rig right here. This is what I call my power rig. This is one I'm throwing whenever I know that I'm around a lot of big fish, whenever I can throw five hooks in my rig, and whenever I just want a big profile with a lot of draw power, this is the one. This is the Hog Farmer 5-wire 8-blade. So it has four wires that have two blades apiece. The thing I like about this rig the most is Hog Farmer, with all their stuff, it's extremely, extremely high quality. They don't spare any expense to make these things, which is the problem with a lot of A-rigs out there. People try to make them super, super cheap. You can get them, you can make them yourself for about $2 or $3 a piece. usually they'll fall apart. This guy right here is definitely not the most natural looking, as it has a whole lot of hardware on it, but super, super high quality. Whenever the water's a little bit more stained, you can get away with having more hardware, and you can throw 5 baits on them year-round, big fish. These things are built rock solid, and you can catch a ton of fish on these, and they're gonna last you a very, very long time. All right, so now that you got your rigs picked out, those are my three that I like, that I've found the most and had the most success with. Let's talk about baits. Baits are very, very important. You can throw a really wide range of different types of baits on these. To me, the best possible baits I've thrown on them are these little Kytex style swim baits. The Fat Impact style swim baits, 3.8 size, are an absolute staple for me. I've used a lot of different swim baits, a lot of different sizes. I've used paddle tails. I've used these guys right here. I think this is RoboWorm that makes this. They're more realistic. And I just keep coming back to these Kytex 3.8 sizes. But I will stagger them a little bit. Now, in a rig like this, when you can have 5 baits and 5 hooks, I have no problem using the same size bait and the same color bait with all 5. That is not a problem. But on a rig like this guy right here, the G-Funk, where you have to have 3 dummies up on top and you got 3 on the bottom that are gonna have hooks, you obviously want to give yourself the best opportunity to catch those fish by eating the baits that have the hooks. I know, rocket science, right? And the way you can do that is with 2 different ways. You can change color and you can change size of the bait. One thing I really like to do is downsize on the teaser. Downsize to these smaller size swing impact fat. I think these are 2.8 sizes. Or you can change the colors by adding these guys. This is more of a Tennessee shad color, 3.8 size, as opposed to one like this guy right here. It's a little bit transparent, but it sticks out a whole lot more and those fish are gonna see it. Even if it is the same size, having one that stands out a whole lot more. To add to that a little bit more, a chartreuse one, right dead center, in the middle, your one that sticks back the furthest and in the middle. You almost always get bit on the chartreuse one if you add a white and chartreuse swim bait back there. Now, there's times when this is too unnatural, they don't want a chartreuse bait, and that's fine. That's when I'll go with something that's really, really white, that's kind of more natural, but it stands out a little bit more from your teasers. Now, if I'm on a really, really good A-rig bite, and I'm catching a lot of fish on it, but I'm trying to get a bigger bite, I'll upside. I'll take all 3 of my baits that have hooks on them, or on a rig like this where you have all 5, I'll take, you know, a couple, 2 or 3 of the different ones, and I'll add a bigger bait. I'll upsize to a 4.8 or a 5.8 size Kytex. Again, I usually like something that's a little bit more opaque to stand out. This is white on the top. I think this one's called Sight Flash. Very, very good color. And put it on your main furthest one back, the middle one, or all 3 of your bottom middle ones. And that's just what I found. Will get bigger size bites. All right, real quick, before we talk about where and how to throw these baits, I want to tell you 2 accessories that are going to be extremely important that a lot of guys overlook when they're getting started with Alabama rig fishing, because it's a little bit extra, more of a financial commitment, I guess. But these are going to help you catch more fish and land more fish, bar none. And that is, 1, a really high quality jig head with a really good hook, and the right type of jig head, and these little screw locks right here. So first, let's talk about the jig head. This is very important. I use 2 different main sizes. This is both the 6-sense head. It's the new one that's up on the site. We got a 3/16 ounce size and we got a 7/16 ounce size. Thing I really like about these new ones is, 1, they have a screw lock on them, so it's gonna hold your bait on there, which if you fish the Alabama rig, it's almost 100% imperative, I've found, to have your bait screw locked on there, your swim bait, that is, because you're gonna get bit a lot, you're gonna get snagged a lot with this bait, and it's gonna pull those swim baits back, and you don't want them to be shot and not usable after the first time that happens. And you definitely don't wanna be pulling that swim bait up the shank every single cast. So a good screw lock is imperative. Another thing, I love these ultra realistic heads, and I love the new 3/0 size hook. So you got a smaller, more stout hook. You're gonna stick everything that bites with these guys right here. You spent the money on the Kytex for the swim baits. You spent a bunch of money on these Alabama rigs. Don't skimp on your actual hook situation. That's what's gonna get those fish to the boat for you. Second thing that's gonna make your life better right here is this little spring lock. This is an Owner CPS spring lock. It's got a centering pin on it. It's absolutely made for this. All you gotta do is twist it onto these dummy rigs right here and they are good to go. This guy is not gonna come off, it's not gonna break. There's 3 different sizes. Go check them out, I'll link everything down below. And last but not least, as far as equipment goes, let's talk about rod, reel, line. A lot of guys have their own ideas of what they like to throw it on, and it's definitely, it's objective. You use whatever you feel is comfortable. This is my setup that I love to throw the rig on. I always throw it on a 7-to-1 gear ratio reel. I can slow it down as much as I want to. I can speed up as much as I want to. This is the most important part to me right here, braided line, 65-pound braided line. I don't use a leader. I don't use fluorocarbon. I'm not throwing a natural-looking bait. This thing has wires on it. It's got freaking blades. It's got swivels, everything else. It's not a natural-looking bait. You don't need to throw it on fluorocarbon line, in my opinion. And the last thing is, I like to make this rig as light as possible so it's as fishable as possible and it's not super hectic to deal with and cast and retrieve all throughout the day. It doesn't sink like a rock, which we'll get into in just a second. So I don't like to make it more than a couple ounces in weight. And at that weight, I love this size rod. This is a 7/6 6-inch Lux rod. It's my flipping stick, but it's not a broomstick. It's more parabolic. It's got a lot of flex throughout the entire rod. A lot of times when you get bit on this bait, they're just going to stop it, and you need that rod to load up a little bit more. But this is a nice light rod. It's not cumbersome. It's not a broomstick. It's not like my 8-ounce, 10-ounce swim bait throwing rods. This is a great rod you can fish all day long. Let's talk a little bit about where and how to throw this bait now. This rigging system now that's absolutely crazy. You know, when this rig came out, I'll tell you how my experience went with it. I went out and I used it. I casted it where I was throwing my crankbaits and my football jigs on rock cover up shallow on rock piles and around shallow brush piles and in muddy water. And I didn't catch anything on it. I got snagged a bunch. I lost a bunch of money because I was throwing it and getting snagged. And it's an expensive investment. Throwing it on I wasn't doing the right stuff with it. I put it on the shelf. And unfortunately, I didn't really pick it up a whole lot and learn how to fish it for a couple years. To me, there's baits that are extremely, extremely versatile, like a jig or like a lipless crankbait or a jerkbait. I don't throw those baits all season long, the lipless crankbait and the jerkbait, that is, but you can catch fish on them all year long. This rig right here is not a bait you'll want to throw all season long. This is a niche bait. It's a technique-specific bait. It's a seasonal-specific and water temperature and clarity-specific bait, but it will catch fish better than pretty much anything else in those scenarios. So let's talk about how and where to throw this bait. So the first thing is throw in cold water. I like to fish this bait in water that's below 50 degrees, and you can fish it as cold as that damn water will get and still catch fish on it. It is mind-blowing. That is why this rig is so effective. If you've been out fishing when the water's 38 degrees, you know that you have to drag a damn jig so you got creeping along, or you got to fish a jerkbait, twitch, pause, and you're going to wait, freaking pour yourself a coffee, smoke a cigarette before you twitch that thing again. It's the slowest way to fish. Not this guy. You cast it out, you reel it in. It's not quite that simple. We'll talk about where to throw it, but there's no other bait system like that's been created and invented like this guy right here that will catch fish, that you can cast it out. You can cover water, most importantly, when that water is very cold and be able to catch them. Not from my experience anyway. So I love to throw this bait in the winter when the water's cold, early spring, late fall, whenever you're in shad lakes. Now that's another thing that's very important. If your lake has a lot of bluegill, crappie, shiner forage, I have not had the success as I do with these baits. On those lakes, I just don't. I flat out don't. Shad ball up, they school up, they move around like no other fish species does. I personally don't know a whole bunch about like blue bag herring lakes and stuff like that because I don't fish any. But shad lakes, these are absolutely the deal. So you got your rig system that I told you about. You got the great heads. You got the good swim baits on them. And you got your rig system for it. You just cast it out and reel it in and catch fish. It's a magic bait. Magic bullet, that is. And you got everything figured out in life, right? No, absolutely not. That's not how it works. And that's what people try to do. And you can catch fish. You catch random fish. But there are very key components to catching fish on this bait. One of them, like we talked about, cold water. The second one that's probably the most important is wind. The third one we're going to talk about as well is water clarity. So let's talk about wind. Wind is as important as anything with this. You can catch fish on this bait on bluff ends. You can catch it on secondary points. You can even just catch it on flat out gravel banks, mud banks, whatever. Wherever those bass can ambush fish, bait fish that is. But they're not going to be there. They're not going to set up there and they're not going to be feeding. They're not going to be looking for balls of bait coming by. Usually if there's not wind, a lot of times those fish in the Ozark Lakes likes to slide out in that 30 to 40 foot range. You'll see them on the bottom. You'll freaking cuss them all day trying to catch them because they don't want to bite anything. And that situation right there is what you saw me and Bradley do the other day, what you're going to see us do a whole lot more, what you're going to see myself do a whole lot more this winter, and that is just run banks, run points, run bluffs, run whatever that's got wind on it. Anything you can find that has wind blowing directly on it, the stronger the better. I don't like giant white caps busting on stuff. In that situation, maybe work your way a little bit further back into the creek so the waves aren't quite as big. It's a little easier to control the boat, fish the bait and stuff, and fish the secondaries that have the wind blowing on them, but that's absolutely key. Now, within those areas, if you have isolated cover, even better. If you have an isolated brush pile you know about that's sitting 15 feet down, you can throw this guy over the top. Absolutely key with wind blowing on it. If you have an isolated dock, an isolated laydown, you can throw these things just about anywhere on isolated cover with a little bit of ripple on the water and you're gonna catch fish. I like to throw them wherever I can throw a jerkbait. This guy works extremely well in those same exact places, except you can fish it even deeper. Now, of course, clean water, like I say with the jerkbait, goes hand in hand with wind. It breaks up the surface clarity. You're going to get more bites in that cleaner water when the wind's pushing in on those areas, especially more vertical cover where those fish can release up and freaking just destroy stuff that looks like this. That's going to be absolutely key. One more thing we're going to talk about that's kind of it's a little bit more off the wall type way to fish this bait, but it's what I've found to be successful when the water is ultra cold, and that is fishing bigger flat pockets. And I'm talking about 15 to 30 foot deep pockets where there's bait, and it's just, I mean, the water is like mid 30s, upper 30s. When the water's below 40 degrees, finding those big flat pockets, maybe at the mouth of a creek, you usually want to be out towards the main lake, but flatter areas, again, with wind pushing into them, clean water, and that's when you want to go with something very, very small. Those fish get really, really specific. They want little tiny baits like this, natural baits, and I'll use as light of rig as I can get away with, but at the same time, I'm going to be fishing it down deep. So I'm going to let that thing sink to the bottom. You want this thing to sink maybe a foot a second, which is pretty slow for something that has three weights on it. So you want it to just drop down there slowly, get it to where you can count it down. You know how long it takes to get down there. And then you're just going to slow roll this really light rig about 1 or 2 feet up above the bottom, up to 5 to 8 feet above the bottom if you're fishing, you know, 35, 40 feet of water. But those areas can be absolutely killer, especially if you graph around and you find areas that have bait. Well, that's all I got for you guys today. You know, hopefully what I've taught you about throwing the Alabama rig will help you get out and catch some more fish. Again, it's very objective. These are the ways that I have found work best for me, the best rigs, the best accessories, the best baits that I've found to catch fish in the best places, of course, too. And I seriously think if you use these same baits, same methods, everything, you're going to go out and catch fish. This rig was an absolute myth to me. It made me scratch my head. I know a lot of people still freaking pound their head against their wall, and they hate throwing this thing because they don't catch anything on it, and they get snagged and lose a bunch of money. It takes 2 hours to retie one. But if you learn how to fish this thing properly, you fish it on braids so those snags, you can pull that hook out of those brush piles or whatever, you're going to learn how to throw this guy, and you're going to catch a whole bunch more fish you never would have caught on anything else. Anyways, though, thank you so much for watching this video. I'm at first. Please go hit the subscribe button if you like these tip videos, and I'll catch you very soon. I'm out of here. Peace.
I'm not sorry. I can't help this love like mine.
I'm not sorry. I can't stop with a love like mine.